Annyeonghaseyo. My name is Paula and I'm a 42-year-old high school teacher from Portugal. Olá Portugal, olá mundo, olá Coreia. So let's talk Korea and find out more about this country, okay? I'm more than 10,000 kilometers away from South Korea, but that doesn't stop me from liking the country. So let's learn some curiosities first. Did you know that it is said that the first female figure-like police officers and the first female medical doctors appeared in Korea? You didn't, right? And also, the first parental leave was established by King Sejong in the 15th century. I've also got to know some cool games to play, like the Yutnuri. I've played this with my students and they loved it. Most Asian countries are also known by their martial arts, and there is one sport that was created in Korea in 1955 and spread all over the world. It's the Taekwondo. And where did I put my Taekwondo tile? It's here! You probably also heard of the Webtoons, and they were created in South Korea too in 2003. I particularly like this online animation because it reminds me of manga and anime, which I love to draw. One of the things that caught my attention in the dramas, for example, were these amazing things called sheet masks. This is wonderful for your skin. And thank God it's sold here in Portugal. I'm a Portuguese, so football is my thing. And did you know that the South Korean football team, the Reds, are one of the best Asian teams out there? I love cinema and I love television, so I was very happy to know that the South Korean film Parasite won the Cannes Film Festival this year. And also, the TV channel Netflix has lots of Korean dramas, and do check Astral Chronicles. It's amazing, really. There are many more interesting things to learn about the Korean way of life and its traditions. For example, how they take off their shoes when they enter their homes, how the system for eating up their floors is one of the oldest in the world, how they pay their respect for one another with the bowing system, the lower the bow, the bigger the respect. Also, in the old days, not cutting the hair was a sign of respect for their parents. If you go to Korea, you will be considered 1 year older, and the blood type is also considered very important. And then there's the food, which is awesome. The tables are beautifully set with lots of side dishes, and it's way different from what we do here in Portugal. I tried some of the recipes with a Portuguese feel, and they were amazing. But there is one thing that I particularly like about the Korean culture, and that is the language. Hangul was created by King Sejong the Great, and it's the only system in the world where the characters try to convey a certain sound. I teach the English and Portuguese languages, and it has been a wonderful process for me learning Hangul in the past 2 years.
Dongjidal, ginagin bamulhan horirul, boyoneyo.
Vou dominar esta longa noite de inverno.
And then there is K-pop. It's almost impossible not to talk about K-pop when talking about the Korean culture. K-pop is basically pop music made in South Korea. You have amazing aesthetics and great vocals and great choreographies, so it's almost impossible to resist this kind of music and this kind of dances. I have a K-pop club in my school, and we have for the past 5, 6 years trying to show K-pop here in Portugal and to the world. And although the language barrier at first was a bit difficult to accept, now the people just focus on the choreographies and the music because it is very nice to hear and very nice to dance. So give it a shot. There's a lot more I could tell you about South Korea, like about the hanboks, the traditional clothes for women, or the historical monuments you can see out there, or the places, the famous places like Jeju Island that has kind of a dark past, and the traditional musical instruments which you still can hear on special occasions. My interest in the Korean culture has been a process of discovering more about the world and more about myself. I love to dance and sing, and now I do it with other people and I have fun. I have also rediscovered my pleasure for drawing after almost 20 years, and I have met people from all over the world that share some kind of interest with me. I have also made some South Korean friends, like the one that gave me this, and a very important father-like figure. Although he is almost 70 and he lives in South Korea and I'm here in Portugal, he took me in as if I was his daughter, and I hope we can meet personally someday. We could be here, talk Korea for ages, but I have to finish, so I will just tell you about two more things that I find adorable in the Korean tradition. One is the igu, and the other are the heart fingers, which are absolutely adorable. Para terminar, quero apenas dizer-vos em português, para não terem preconceitos e descobrirem um pouco mais acerca do mundo que vos rodeia, sejam países próximos de vós, sejam países mais distantes, não tenham medo e tentem conhecê-los, porque ao conhecerem essas novas tradições e culturas, podem também conhecer um pouco mais acerca de vocês mesmos e abrir os vossos horizontes. Adeus! Annyeong! Bye bye!